Well, you've likely heard the expression, dead men tell no tales. But a death behind bars in a Minnesota jail proves otherwise. And as investigative reporter A.J. Legault tells us tonight, it is now leading to a federal lawsuit.
What do we want?
Justice!
What do we want?
Now!
Outside the Beltrami County Jail, last year, families who have lost loved ones behind these walls gathered.
We're here protesting against Beltrami County Jail and the unjust deaths of people that are in jail without getting proper care.
Tamara Poppy is among the crowd, lying in the street, a symbolic die-in.
The worst thing is just thinking about what my uncle was feeling the last, you know, two or three days of his life, asking for help and not getting anything.
A KARE 11 investigation exposed how, in 2019, Tamara's uncle, 63-year-old Bruce Lundmark, a Vietnam-era Navy veteran in jail on drug charges, begged for days to see a doctor as he writhed in pain. However, Bruce never even got to see a nurse. Instead of medical care, because of overcrowding in the Beltrami jail, he was just bussed off to Clearwater County. A nurse with Men Correctional Care, the private, for-profit company with multi-million dollar contracts to provide medical treatment in both Beltrami and Clearwater jails, wrote, patient released to another county prior to being seen. Shortly after arriving at the Clearwater jail, still in the booking process, Bruce became unresponsive, throwing up what guards described as a brown tobacco-like liquid. And he died.
He had a GI bleed, and he bled to death internally, and no one did anything about it.
Certified forensic nurse Melissa Becker is an independent expert KARE 11 asked to review Bruce's medical records.
What words would you use to describe the KARE he received?
Shocking. Horrifically shocking is what I would say. He didn't receive any KARE. He received no KARE while he was there.
Bruce's family did not suspect anything was wrong until they found this scrawled note in his jail belongings. If I die, sue the sh** out of Beltrami Jail. That's exactly what Bruce's family is now doing, filing this federal lawsuit alleging the jails and Men Correctional KARE engaged in negligence and medical malpractice leading to wrongful death. Zorislav Leiderman is the Lundmark family's attorney.
What I see going on in Beltrami County is just complete disregard for human life. This isn't an isolated incident.
Bruce's death happened a year after Hardell Sherrill, whose death in the Beltrami jail resulted in the state, earlier this year, stripping Men's owner, Todd Leonard, of his doctor's license.
Can you tell us why Hardell Sherrill was left in that cell without medical KARE until he died?
Leonard has refused KARE 11's numerous requests for interviews about these deaths and others on his watch.
Okay. Why don't you answer any of our questions, sir?
Bruce's family says they, too, have more questions than answers.
You know, at what point did he know or think that he was going to die and nobody was going to be there with him or help him?
Both Beltrami and Clearwater are among the growing number of Minnesota counties to recently end their contracts with Todd Leonard and Men Correctional KARE, who remain under active federal and state investigations for Hardell Sherrill's death. For KARE 11 Investigates, I'm A.J. Legault.